What is up, guys? This is Matt Lemire here. I hope all of you guys are having a wonderful day. And it is my pleasure to be able to show you guys the experience of Railtown 1897 in Jamestown, California. This place is a very important in both railroad and movie history, as this was the filming location for a plethora of Western movies, such as Pale Rider and one of my favorites, obviously, Back to the Future Part 3. And there's so many others I could list off right now, but it's, and also there are a bunch of television shows that were shot here as well, like Petticoat Junction. And, but I'll get into more of that stuff later. So I really hope that you guys enjoy today's vlog. So the depot here at Jamestown has been turned into a store, and this is where you can buy tickets, and the train comes through here and takes you on a loop that we will be riding on today. It's a 6-mile loop, about 45 minutes, and I'm really looking forward to it.
Before then, we were shooting the Western, and a lot of those scenes come up here. The two of the more recent ones were Unforgiven, which was shot by Clint Eastwood, won the Academy Award. There's a whole scene, folks coming in on the train, and shows Sierra Railway number 3, the locomotive you can see in the roundhouse, is used in lots of movies. The other movie is Back to the Future 3, which is almost entirely shot up here. They actually built the set for the town off the tracks, and that was here. Finally burned down after a couple of years. The number 3 locomotive was the locomotive that pushed the DeLorean. And she just threw the switch, and it's back to being a white diamond, which again shows that it's set for the main line. The lights are on this end of the locomotive, because that's the direction it's going to be moving.
Television program called
Petticoat Junction. I'm old enough to remember that. That's what I'm sorry to say. Not because the program was bad. But you know, there were all those gorgeous young ladies who appeared to be taking a bath.
Our pride and joy here is the number 3. She was built in 1891 in Paterson, New Jersey. She's only 127 years old, which is not bad. I wish I were in good shape as she is right now. Long story short, this has been in over 200 movies and television series episodes. It's been around. It was out of service from 1932 to 1947, sitting right out here, but it was rehabbed for the movies. Fortunately, the movies came in and invested a lot of money, which made it possible to keep the number 3. And then, in 2010, it was rehabbed again. Not only was it rehabbed, but a new boiler was added. And the rehab only cost about $1,500,000. Now, I have no idea what the original cost was, but I'm sure it was a lot less than $100,000 when it was built.
The next part I want to go to is the prop shed, where they used different props to make the engines reflect their respective time periods. Coming inside now, you can see all the different props, and obviously they have their Back to the Future Part 3 stuff. There's the part of the caboose that Doc and Marty hang on to. There's a little plaque for it. And then number 3's lamp to make her 131. And then all her funnels. Yeah, there's the balloon stack that she wore in the movie. That's so awesome. There she is. And then her blown stack when the red Presto lock fires off.
There's the scene from the movie.
And then here are all her other stacks from countless other movies, such as Unforgiven, The Adventures of Briscoe County Jr., Dodge City. That's the Dodge City stack, that little diamond stack right there. And then coming over here is the whole timeline of all the movies and TV shows that she's been in. And what's pretty cool is on the bottom of that little film reel is the storyboarding of the whole train chase sequence from Back to the Future Part 3. So I'm coming over here to highlight some of my notable ones. Petticoat Junction, for some of my older viewers who are watching this. That's definitely a notable show. Bonanza. There she is in Bonanza with the diamond stack. And of course, why not show it? Back to the Future, Part 3. There she is in all of her glory. So, it's pretty damn awesome. Just wanted to kind of show that. Pretty damn cool. On the other side of the shed, you can see that there's more rolling stock that's here on site. Central Pacific passenger car, little pump car, and then a photo opportunity embracing the park's connection to Petticoat Junction. Wanted to end the video in the gift shop because there's some pretty cool merchandise around here, so let's check it out.
Yeah, see, you got your Back to the Future Part 3 shirt, and then this one I think is so dope.
Next thing you know, the two will be back.
Greetings from Hill Valley 1885. It's got the Jules Verne train and the DeLorean on it. That's pretty awesome. So, really embracing the Back to the Future stuff. I love this shirt. It's like a Hawaiian shirt, but it's with trains in it.
I love
CP Huntington number 1, which is a train at the California State Railroad Museum. So what did you think of this experience, Dad?
Yeah, I loved it, man. Informative. I love the West. Always love the West. I love trains.
Oh yeah, big time. Now I'm gonna give myself a number 3 pen and number 3 coffee. So, there you go.
Alright guys, I think that's going to be it for today's vlog. You know, I just wanted to do something a little more adventurous and come out here and witness some film and railroad history. So, I think that's where I'm going to wrap it. As always, to get more content like this, remember to tune in. Same Matt time, same Matt channel. Thank you for watching, guys. And remember, the future is whatever you make of it. Take care, you guys.